President Wafe.
We welcome our president.
Oguano.
Our beloved one. Who accepted everyone to worship freely. I say, his son of the president. Thank you for visiting us for the second time in the same place. We are so grateful. You are really the president who deserves to rule Uganda. The time is so limited, though we have a lot. You're most welcome, and we are glad to see you in this place.
Your Excellency, having mentioned those few remarks, there is nobody who can nature his youth to become useful citizens, God fearing, and therefore respecting the leaders in government. We can assure you, Excellency, that through Prophet David, you have 100% support from Universal Apostles Fellowship Church of Christ. The entire work of religious leaders to transform the followers. We are so proud that we have a prophet, indigenous, founded in Uganda, who is committed to preach the gospel of righteousness to the entire world. I know you are time back, but we shall request that let this not be the last time. We have made many attempts to host you, Excellence, and have been many barriers. This youth have come here to solidify our stand together with you. Come 2026, you will have a clock fort in Universal. This are all your youth. There is nobody who can bring a different doctrine to us. For us, we can work on ourselves. If somebody preaches anything against it or contrary to the government programs, we deal with them ourselves. We cast them out of our group. So thank you very much, Your Excellency. With due diligence, I would request, Your Excellency, in appreciation to our prophet, just to mention that he was a youth leader in this church from 1999 until 2013. When you came here, and you ordained him as a prophet, you had a handover ceremony that was in this ground. We want, therefore, to cherish his leadership. He has transformed his youth into useful citizens. I am a youth leader, but we have old roots within Uganda and outside, just preaching the word of God. Prophet David has committed himself. There is no other doctrine other than the vision and the mission statement that I've made before you. We are here purely to preach the gospel of righteousness to the entire world. When the world gets going, God anoints a prophet. So, with those few remarks, Your Excellency, if it is permissive before you, allow us, as the youth, to present a small gift to our prophet for the great work he has done to us. We have been the youth, to be useful citizens, to themselves, their families, and their entire nation. May God bless you so much. Okay. I think he has granted us. We can just use 1 minute this opportunity, Your Excellency. We don't have much to donate to this man of God for the great work he has done for us. But what export the gospel to prosper to all nations, be within and outside. He is not a politician, never. He is here to support the leadership that comes from above. Next time we have time, Your Excellency, I will tell you why we have a solid stand to support you. Prophet Noah, may his soul rest in peace. In the 1990s, he prophesied that there is going to come a leader who will restore his country, and he will be from the west. He will be a bold-headed man. When he appeared in 1986, he told us that that is the man and that he will rule his country and peace when God gives his necessary. So anyone that does that, we shall not deviate from our own prophets. We are today witnessing that prophecy come true. As the youth of Universal, we are requesting, we have one challenge. Your Excellency, there is a problem of unemployment. For us, if you can only get us farmland, we shall do one up to this country. And what you want is value addition. I know the rest will be in the report. Thank you very much. Your Excellency, bring that gift here. Your Excellency, you want us to give our prophet a token of appreciation. In that there, that car that stands in front of us. As the youth of Universal. So, Prophet David, we want to thank you for the great work you've done to us. And we want to assure you, with the peace and tranquility given by his able leadership of His Excellency, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, Your Excellency, it will be one day we shall buy a plane for our prophet to take the gospel outside this country. May God bless you. I say all this for God and my country. Thank you very much. Your Excellency, on behalf of the youth of the Universal Apostles Fellowship Church of ITG, we would like to have this vehicle to our prophet in order to further the gospel of righteousness, not only in Uganda, but even outside Uganda. We have a noble cause to preach the gospel of righteousness. I repeat, Your Excellency, Prophet David has not trained rebels. But I want to thank you for your able leadership. Even when there is rebel last, that you do such acts. Your Excellency, your intelligence system has proved this beyond a reasonable doubt. And we are happy that you are here. Thank you for being a father. Thank you for being a good leader. May God bless you. This is the floor of God. God bless you. I am the director of the prophet. Thank you.